So, Laz, who are we picking up today?
Well, we're going up to see Liz at Port Macquarie.
Ah, Elizabeth, yes. You like Elizabeth,
don't
you?
I do. I really like Elizabeth.
She's got a great sense of humour.
She does. She's always dancing on Friday night drinks.
She is. This is going to be a fun one. I'm looking forward to this one. And here she is. What on earth has she got with her today? Is that a duck?
And a bear?
And a bear. Oh, this is going to be a fun story. Hi, Elizabeth. How are you going?
Good.
Get back, Larry. Come on.
I'm going.
Get back. Here you go.
I'm always getting pushed around.
Welcome.
Hello, and welcome to Port Macquarie.
Thank you so much.
What piece of equipment could you not live without at ORS?
So this is one that I brought with me.
I was wondering what these were.
This is Robbie the Rabbit.
Robbie the Rabbit.
He is my telehealth companion.
Hi, Robbie.
He does everything with my under seven kids because it's so hard to keep them on the screen. So
yep.
Robbie does story time with the kids.
Oh,
Robbie
nice.
Does exercises. So he goes marching and he does star jumps. And
yep.
Robbie does and some handwriting and he plays with Play-Doh. And generally the kids love him.
Yeah, yeah.
And I've even had a couple of kids after COVID when they came back out of lockdown who brought their own teddy bears in to have Play-Doh to Robbie.
So did they have names? Did Robbie have friends?
Yes, he did.
Oh, that's awesome.
So they had little play dates and little photo shoots with him because he was such a character during the 2 years of lockdown.
Oh, that's awesome.
He was my $5 purchase from Kmart and he's been the best therapy tool. Like, he's not officially a therapy tool.
Oh, he is now. We've got new therapy bunny Robert.
Yeah. And he just, he goes and he goes and he goes.
I got a question for you, Elizabeth. So obviously you don't want to work with kids. What do OTs do with kids? So I hear often, OTs work really well with children with ADHD and autism and, array of different spectrum disorders. What do OTs specifically do with them?
A lot of different things and depends on what their needs are. So it could be anything from working on their dressing and their showering to working on social skills, so making friends, keeping eye contact, conversations, to handwriting, to transitioning from from classes or from at home from one activity to the next.
So say a really young client, like I'm actually talking from my child, so I have a child who we're thinking has ADHD and we keep hearing OT is the perfect fit. You need to see an OT to help with emotional regulation, transitions, etc. So this isn't really a carpool question, I'm just asking you my own questions now. How would an OT specifically slot in and help there?
So a lot of routines. So we'd put in a lot of pictures, a lot of okay, well, you go from step one to step two to step three. A lot of, okay, if you want to make a cheese sandwich, you'd get the bread out, picture one, picture two, picture three. If you're, okay, you're at school today, but today's the day you have sports, so therefore you have a picture of the school uniform. So a lot of just getting them into that routine and getting them used to the fact of transitioning from one to the next so that when they go to school, they get, they get overwhelmed or if they get upset because they can't deal with the separation.
Gotcha.
We have the whole, mum and dad will be back soon, it's okay.
There you go. Oh, I'd always wondered. Now I know.
Oh, I do everything. That's one of the good parts about this job. It's so broad.
It must be so rewarding.
Yeah.
Yeah, you must go home with a big smile and a good feeling of accomplishment each day.
Depends on the day.
Yeah, isn't that the truth for most jobs?
So, let's play a game. Two truths and a lie.
Oh, I like two truths and a lie. We suck at this game, by the way. We don't do very
we're
well.
Still trying to figure out.
We're still trying to work out what Nikita's truth and lie was. We're not very good at this one.
Okay. I own a house in Port Macquarie.
Okay. Well, tell us them all and then we'll guess. And Larry, don't blow your answers out. We've got to be strategic.
I have three brothers.
Yep.
And I have been working as an OT since I left school.
Oh,
I think I...
You want to go first, Larry?
Yeah.
What's your truth?
You've only got two brothers.
My lie is... You were working as an OT since you left school.
Yes, you're right. I did not go to uni until I was in my
30s. Yeah. And why? Why did that come about later?
So I had a workplace accident 15 years ago now.
Yep.
And I couldn't continue in my current job, so I had to sort of retrain myself and look at what other options were available.
Yep. Okay.
I always wanted to go into medical of some description.
Yep.
Nursing, I couldn't do the whole blood thing and bedpans and...
Yeah, I hear this so often.
No, yeah. I couldn't do that.
To finish it out, a bit of a fun question. If you could be any animal, Elizabeth, what would you choose and why?
And I have another prop.
Another prop?
Meet Percy.
Percy the duck.
Hello, Percy.
Percy, again, is another one of my very good therapy tools, and I have had a duck in my every office I've been in for the last 5 years.
Yep.
He's a big duck.
He is.
Percy likes his frogs.
Yeah, and so I just, yeah, he's just another conversation piece. We use him for bathing practice. We use him for everything.
Yep.
So for me, he's just versatile. So if I could be any animal, it'd be a duck, because you can just waddle around, you know, just do what you want, when you want, and just basically, no, most people don't disturb you.
As true as that. Yeah, true. I love it. All right, so you're a duck. I've got your penis.
Oh, that's so bad.
Oh, awesome. Well, I think this is where we were dropping you, right, Elizabeth?
It is. Thank you very much, boys.
I'll pull in here behind this blue car. Well, thank you for riding with Trav and Lance. It was a pleasure having you.
Oh, thank you very much for giving me a lift.
No worries. Good luck, guys. Good luck, Percy. We'll see you soon.
We'll see you next time you're in Port Macquarie.
See you soon. Thanks, Elizabeth. How good was that, Larry?
That's awesome.
I need a duck.
You do need a duck. You need a purse.
I need a bigger duck.
A bigger duck? We can get you a big duck for your office if you like, Lance. Oh, I love meeting Elizabeth. It was good to finally come up and hang out with her. She was a lot of fun.